In this video, we'll be continuing on to the second page of the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Solving Rational Equations Part 2, or Solving Rational Equations Hard. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access all of these free KutaSoftware website worksheets. Now, picking up with number 9, remember in order to combine rationals through addition or subtraction, we need to have the same denominator. So on this right-hand side, because r minus 2 is equivalent to r minus 2, we can go ahead and add r plus 4 and 6 together. So we'll have 1 over r plus 3 equal to r plus 4 plus 6, which is r plus 10 over r minus 2. Now, I want this r minus 2 out of the denominator, so I'll multiply both sides by r minus 2. And that will help me cancel out r minus 2 on the right. I also want r plus 3 out of the denominator, so in that same step, I'll also multiply by r plus 3. So now you can see that r plus 3 will cancel out on that left-hand side. So now that I have nothing within my denominator, because r minus 2 divided by r minus 2 is 1, and r plus 3 divided by r plus 3 is 1, I'll go ahead and write out what I have. So I have r minus 2 times 1, which is r minus 2, and that's equivalent to r plus 10 times r plus 3. R plus 10 times r plus 3. My next step, I'm going to FOIL, multiplying my first terms, outside terms, inside terms, and last terms together. So I'll have r minus 2 still on my left-hand side, and that's equal to r times r, which is r squared, plus r times 3, which is 3r, plus 10 times r, which is 10r, plus 10 times 3, which is 30. Now I'll combine my like terms on the right-hand side, 3r, 10r, and I'll also subtract r from both sides. So I'll be combining 3r, 10r, and 1r together. And while I'm at it, I'll add 2 to both sides as well so that I have 0 on my left-hand side. So I'm going to be combining 30 and 2. Because r minus r is 0, negative 2 plus 2 is 0. So 0 on my left-hand side, that's equal to r squared plus 3r plus 10r is 13r. And when I take away 1r from that, I'll get 12r. And then plus 30 plus 2, which is 32. Now I'm going to factor this quadratic. What two numbers multiply to give me a positive 32 and add to give me a positive 12? Looking at the factors of 32, that will work. That will be 8 and 4, where both 8 and 4 are positive. 8 times 4 is 32, and 8 plus 4 is 12. So rewriting this quadratic as 0 equal to r plus 8 times r plus 4. So in order to solve, I'm going to see when r plus 8 is equivalent to 0 and when r plus 4 is equivalent to 0, because 0 times any quantity is 0. So if r plus 8 is 0, when multiplied to r plus 4, it will equal 0. And when r plus 4 is 0, when multiplied to r plus 8, it will also give us 0. So r plus 8 equals 0 when, if I subtract 8 from both sides of that equation, r equals negative 8. And r plus 4 equals 0 when, if I subtract 4 from both sides of that equation, r equals a negative 4. So I have two solutions for number 9, that's negative 8 and negative 4. And I'll go ahead and write them in set notation. But when r equals negative 8, then the left side is equal to the right side. And when r equals negative 4, the left side is equal to the right side. Let's continue on to number 10. In number 10, right away, I'll be able to combine my fractions on the right-hand side because they have the same denominator. Also, on my left-hand side, I'm going to simplify the denominator. So what two numbers multiply to give me 25 and add to give me a negative 10? So looking at the factors of 25, that will be negative 5 and negative 5, because negative 5 plus negative 5 is negative 10, and negative 5 times negative 5 is a positive 25. So I'll have a squared minus 4a minus 12 all over a minus 5 times a minus 5, and that's going to be equivalent to 6 plus a minus 3, which 6 minus 3 will be 3, so that's 3 plus a. Or you can write it as a plus 3. And that's all over a minus 5. Now, I want to cancel out both my denominators. And lucky enough for me, I have a minus 5 on the right and a minus 5 squared on the left. So if I multiply both sides by a minus 5 squared, I will indeed cancel out both my denominators. Because a minus 5 squared will cancel out a minus 5 times a minus 5, and a minus 5 squared will cancel out a minus 5 in the denominator, but leave me with a minus 5 in my numerator. So I'll have a squared minus 4a minus 12 equivalent to a plus 3 times a minus 5. Now I'll FOIL this out, multiplying a to a to negative 5, a to 3, or 3 to a, and then 3 to negative 5. So I'll get a squared minus 4a minus 12 equal to a squared, since a times a is a squared, plus a times negative 5, which is negative 5a, plus 3 times a, which is 3a, plus 3 times negative 5, which is negative 15. Now for number 10, what I'm going to do, I'm going to subtract a squared from both sides. And when I do so, a squared cancels out a squared, and a squared cancels out a squared. So I want my variable a on one side of the equation and my constant on the other side in order to solve, because now all I have is a linear equation. So in order to do that, I will add 4a to both sides. So I'm going to be adding negative 5a to 3a and 4a, and this 4a will cancel out the negative 4a, but then as opposed to adding 12 to both sides to get 0, I'll add 15 to both sides in order to isolate that variable on my right-hand side. So negative 12 plus 15 is a positive 3, and that's going to equal negative 5a plus 3a, which is negative 2a, but then when I add 4a to that, I'll get a positive 2a. So rewriting that equation, I have 3 equal to 2a, and when I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that 3 halves is equal to a. So I have one solution in number 10, and that is 3 halves. When a is equal to 3 halves, my equation will hold true. And again, that's because I was able to cancel out my a squareds on both sides, and then I solved the rest of the equation for a to get that a equals 3 halves is the answer. Let's continue on to number 11. In number 11, I have the same denominator on my left-hand side, n plus 3 and n plus 3. So I will be able to combine my numerators over that denominator with addition. So 1 plus n squared plus 6n plus 5, I'll be adding that 1 to the 5 to get n squared plus 6n plus 6 all over n plus 3. That's going to be equal to n minus 3. Now, I want n plus 3 out of my denominator. So in order to do that, I'm going to be multiplying both sides by n plus 3. So multiplying my left-hand side by n plus 3 and my right-hand side by n plus 3, you can see that n plus 3 will cancel out. So I indeed eliminate my denominator. So I'll have n squared plus 6n plus 6 equivalent to, let's FOIL out, n times 3, 3 times n, and 3 times 3. N times n is n squared, plus n times 3 is 3n, plus negative 3 times n, which is negative 3n, plus 3 times 3, and that's a negative 3 times 3, which is negative 9. So you can see that 3n plus negative 3n will equal 0. So n squared minus 9 is on my right-hand side, and I have n squared plus 6n plus 6 on my left-hand side. So just like in number 10, if I subtract both sides by my variable squared, in this case it's n squared minus n squared is 0. So my n squared will cancel out to leave me with a linear equation. I have 6n plus 6 equal to negative 9. So in order to isolate my term with n, I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides. So I'll have 6n remaining on my left-hand side, and that's going to be equal to negative 9 minus 6, which is a negative 15. And then I'll divide both sides by 6 to get that n is equal to negative 15 sixths. However, both 15 and 6 are divisible by 3. So dividing 15 by 3, I'll get 5. And dividing 6 by 3, I'll get 2. But remember, that's negative 15 sixths. So we'll have negative 5 halves as our solution. So negative 5 halves is the answer in number 11. So feel free to double check and plug in negative 5 halves for n, and the left-hand side of this equation will indeed be equal to the right-hand side. Now lastly in this video, I'm going to go over problem number 12. And this is just a reminder that if I do a problem one way, that does not mean there's not another way or even a better way to solve the problem. So feel free to try your own methods, but just know that you need to get the same solution in order for the answer to be correct. So in number 12, notice that 2, 4x, and 2x are all even numbers, but more specifically, I'm looking at this 4x. I need to cancel out 2x, 2, and 4x, but 2 is a factor of 4, and x is a factor of x. So if I multiply my right-hand side by 4x, and I multiply my left-hand side by 4x, 4x times 1 half is 4x over 2, and that's going to be equal to 4x times x squared minus 7x plus 10 all over 4x, and then we'll subtract 4x over 2x. So you can see all I did was distribute this 4x to the first fraction and the second fraction on my right-hand side. So notice that 4x will cancel out with 4x, x will cancel out with x in that second fraction, and also note that 4 is divisible by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. So I'll have 2x equal to x squared minus 7x plus 10, and then 4 divided by 2 is 2, so minus 2. Now I'll subtract 2x from both sides, and I'll also combine 10 and 2. That way, I'll have 0 equal to some quadratic, and that quadratic will be x squared minus negative 7 minus 2x will be minus 9x plus 10 minus 2 will be plus 8. Now let's factor this quadratic. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me positive 8 and add to give me negative 9. And that will be 1 and 8, where both 1 and 8 are negative. Negative 1 plus negative 8 is negative 9. And negative 1 times negative 8 is positive 8. So I'll rewrite this quadratic as 0 equal to x minus 1 times x minus 8. Now I'm going to see when x minus 1 equals 0 and when x minus 8 equals 0. X minus 1 equals 0 when, adding 1 to both sides, x equals a positive 1, because 1 minus 1 is 0. And then x minus 8 equals 0 when, adding 8 to both sides, x equals a positive 8, because 8 minus 8 equals 0. Therefore, I have two solutions in number 12, that's positive 1 and positive 8. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And before you continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet, please remember to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your peers. All likes, subscriptions, and shares are greatly appreciated.